I gotta give it to Miley Cyrus, one of the few fucking pop stars to use the word fuck that often. Fucking A. Big shout out to homegirl Miley Cyrus. Let's get into this new Kevin Gates here. Also, don't forget, we still got that shit streaming. Caddy Mac and Kevin Gates, yo bitch, on all motherfucking platforms. Go cop that shit. Let's get into this new Kevin Gates here called Sweet Dreams. Check it out.
DJ so far gone on the mix up.
Mindset currently, niggas don't worry me. White Panam airplane currency. Pussy niggas say they wanna murder me. Steam paper, steam haters, steam laser, cream wafers. Red one of my view, fly a lot of niggas living lies. I go hard, not a dream chaser. Had your baby, king cake you. Sliced all up on a king's table. Machine scrape you when your bricks by the land. Drop it when it's all white, cook it in a pan. Standing over pots while it's cooking in the pan. Looking for the grams, I can put them in your hand. Face card, nigga got a face card. Chopping out a great car, spitting with an AR. Out the mud with the drugs, now we got a race car. 11-5 on the side, I ain't take a day off. Bread won the quiet, get a hustle for the payoff. Hit the trap, stay down, guess it kinda paid off. Ripping in the paint, I'm a bam on something. You thinking about a slam, I was talking about a cutlass. Got it out the mud, everything push button. Nigga never gave nothing, now I'm coming through stunting.
It's hard to call it radio when it's this out of the box.
Listen to that. Man, you know just what to say.
You might be a redneck.
Get it in.
Fox News alert on several dramatic new developments.
Frank Sinatra.
You're a delightful audience.
Let's go to Margaritaville.
To the 10, to the 5. Touchdown.
This is satellite radio. Welcome to SiriusXM.
Big shout out once again to our affiliates at SiriusXM. If you want to check out SiriusXM for yourself, see all the great channels, features they have to offer, go to tinyurl.com/SiriusXM CEO Radio, all one word. Bring it right to our sign up page. Guaranteed we'll get you the best deal. This next song we got is by Lana Del Rey called Serial Killer. It's weird because I was just kind of talking about some serial killer type shit with my homegirl. She's talking about going into mortuary services and like cremating people for a living and shit. And we started getting on this weird conversation about But if you cremate them with perfume or something that smells good, so that way the ashes always smell like something to remind people of something. And then, I don't know, I just came up with, what if you stuffed a turkey with a chicken with a duck, like a turducken? And you know how they take those in the South and they stuff them inside an alligator? Instead of an alligator, shove it all inside grandma's ass. It's a grandma turducken. It's fucking awesome. I don't know, I guess that's some serial killer shit, though. Now that I really think about it, I'm like, yeah, that's shit serial killers would do. I've been really into, like, you ever get into, like, the serial killer documentaries and conspiracies? Like, I don't know. Lately, I've been getting real into those things lately. Just, like, watching all sorts of shit. Not, like, Cold Case Files. I don't really like that. That's fucking just, that guy's voice annoys me. But, like, the fucking, just the documentaries in general about individual serial killers. There's one thing I've been looking up, maybe if one of the listeners out there, if you guys fucking find some info on it or have some info, if you're weird, or not weird, but if you've been in some weird situations with it, maybe you've ran across it, if you're in the area where it's at, allegedly at, maybe you could tell me a little something about it. Hit me up on Instagram, the_CEO_official, or the_CEO_show_, all one word. Hand of Death Cult out in Everglades. Hand of Death Cult. Now, Henry Lee Lucas and Otis Toole, you know, they're the ones who killed John Walsh's son. They were, like, mass murderers, some of the biggest mass murderers in the country and shit. Were gay lovers that went out and murdered whole families, all sorts of crazy shit. They spoke about being a part of the Hand of Death cult. And they said it was a secret cult that was out in the Everglades where they'd meet just deep in the Everglades in an undisclosed location. Also, some abandoned warehouse over by a place called Monty's over near the pier in the fucking Everglades and shit over in that area. You know, they were contract killers and all the shit they said for the cult, as well as they helped with human sacrifices, things like that. They would eat people. Everyone thought they were crazy. No one took it seriously. Cops searched Everglades once, but, I mean, how are you really going to search the fucking Everglades? It's a big-ass swamp area. Like, anything would be going down out there. But then, if you look back, Richard Ramirez, the Night Stalker, that motherfucker, and he was all the way out in California, but he also mentioned the Hand of Death cult. Now, if you look it up nowadays, I remember when, back in the day, it's weird, since Facebook's come in and everything else, like, the internet's been so censored. That's why, if you want to look up something that you can't find on Google, go to Yahoo. Because if you look, when you look up certain shit on Google, at the very bottom, it'll say, some of these links were blocked from your view because of this law or this reason or our policy on this. And they're just like, no, you don't get to fucking have access to that. Go to Yahoo. They don't have regulations like that. But, anyway, you know, back in the day, before they started searching their internet, you could find a lot of information on Hand of Death cult. There was also, you know, pictures of the tattoos that fucking Otis Toole had on his hand, that Henry Lucas had on his hand, that motherfucking Richard Ramirez, and there's a few other fucking serial killers that had that same motherfucking tattoo on their hand, the Hand of Death cult tattoo. Now, if you look, the fucking tattoo has been removed from all images of that. Like, if you look, it just looks like a regular hand, no tattoo. You can't find anything on it. If you look up Hand of Death cult Everglades on Google, not shit. You won't find a motherfucking thing on it. Like, real shit. You'll find some Reddit pages of people telling their opinions about it, but you won't find any actual hard evidence. It's like it's been erased from fucking existence. And it's crazy because, like, fucking, there's been a lot of stuff erased from existence, you know? And Mandela affected and shit. I don't know, I've been really weirded out by the Mandela effect. I didn't believe in it at first. I thought it was just people who were so fucking arrogant they wouldn't believe they were wrong about remembering something the wrong way. But someone showed me some proof one day. Tiny Toons. Motherfucking Tiny Toons. And Looney Tunes. The tune was spelled T-O-O-N-S, like cartoons. Everyone agrees on that, right? Look it up now. There's certain pages that'll show it spelled like that until you click the link. T-U-N-E-S, and they say that's the way it's been spelled the entire time. Bull fucking shit. Bull fucking shit. I bet you, they even changed the old school Space Jam jerseys to say that now. I don't know how the Mandela effect works. Some people say that it's, you know, people going back in time and fucking with shit. That's how people fucking remembered that fucking Shazam and Kazam. The fucking, there was Kazam, which was the fucking movie with Shaq being a genie. Shazam, Sinbad was the genie. There's people that have had reports of having the VHS, then it's just disappeared from their fucking places, or they've been threatened if they try to expose it. It's weird shit. Somewhere I have an original VHS of motherfucking Space Jam. I want to see if the fucking spelling's been changed on that or not. And I'm going to dig it out one day when I get finished unpacking. I still haven't fully unpacked it for moving to a new house and moving to a new studio and shit. Still got some shit we're setting up, but one of these days I'm going to do that. I'm going to expose it on Instagram. The government will probably kill me for it. That's whatever. Let's get into Lana Del Rey, Serial Killer. Check it out.
Wish I may, wish I might find my one true love tonight. Do you think that it could be you? If I pray really tight, get into a fake butterfly.
Like a game boy.